Anime Batman! God, that was lame. Hello and welcome to my review of Batman Gotham Knight. Before we begin, I'd like to inform you of a few changes to my reviews. For starters, the scoring system will be different. Instead of out of 5 type scoring, it will now be graded like an essay. Also, all future reviews will feature no form of possible copyright infringements, so no trailers or movie footage or even game footage. This way, it will make those spud brains and cock-dining pansies of Viacom from having another period and stop harassing YouTube. I know it's kind of sad to downgrade the reviews, but I'd like to keep my channel up and running to share with you my thoughts and give the fandom more grey hairs. The only exception to this ruling will be the eagerly anticipated review of Super Smash Bros. Brawl, which I feel needs to have the footage to help emphasise my points and opinions. Hello everyone, my name is Percy Positive. I'd like to let everyone know that whenever that DC makes a review, mine will be up shortly after his. Isn't that super? Don't seem to know what happened there, but anyway. That's the point regarding the reviews. Now, enjoy my review of Batman Gotham Knight. If anyone isn't familiar with this DVD, here is a quick explanation. Batman Gotham Knight is set in between Batman Begins and The Dark Knight. It was written by some of the best comic book writers in the industry, but the catch this time is it's drawn by some of the most talented anime artists from Japan. It's split into several stories, similar to that of the Animatrix. The first story, Have I Got a Story for You? The first short story is a bunch of skateboarding kids tell their stories of how they saw Batman in action to their friend. Their descriptions of Batman showcase my deepest gripes with Japanese animation. The first description was Batman as some kind of satanic shadow creature. I felt this was kind of lame and didn't suit Batman's design. The second described him as a man-bat-based creation. This was the weakest design because it's basically an anthropomorphic bat with a bat symbol on his chest. And the third showcased him as the cliché robot. Well, it is a Japanese production after all. I'm kind of glad that another kid didn't tell a story. I was just waiting for a Batman with tentacles and a schoolgirl villain. The story ends when Batman appears fighting a thug, who looks like a cross between Sam Fisher and a foot ninja from the TMNT. He saves the day and the kid tells them his story. The art style of this first production is kind of odd since anime tends to be detail-driven, opposed to the more cartoony approach. I really like the look of this as it reminded me at times of Transformers Animated, mainly how Batman appeared to have the disproportionate limbs. Overall, the story really stunk. The kid's dialogue was lame and the funky art is the only thing that was interesting. C-. Crossfire. The second story is about how a Gotham detective does not trust Batman and sees himself clearing up Batman's antics. He and his partner soon find themselves caught in the middle of a gunfight between Sal Maroni and the Russian. That has to be the worst villain name I have ever heard. On top of that, the Russian is a complete pussy. He stands still while his men do all the work, and it takes one punch from Batman to put him out. Batman saves the two cops from death and tells them that James Gordon has a good judge of character. This story was drawn by the people behind Ghost in the Shell and Blood the Last Vampire, and seeing how Blood's my favourite anime movie means I think the art, music and style of this piece is completely fucking sweet. The music was gothic and deep that draws you into a terror that Batman is capable of. Plus, the image of him in the flames was well animated. The other effects of blood splatter, metal crunching, and fire were a nice touch. Overall, a vast improvement over Have I Got a Waste of Time for You. Great script, top-notch voice acting, and one I'll go back to. A+. Field Test. Lucius Fox provides Bruce Wayne with new technology that can deflect bullets. He tests his device to settle the confrontation between Sal Maroni and the Russian. That name still sucks. But during the conclusion, someone tries to shoot Batman. The device deflects the bullet and injures one of the henchmen. Batman returns the device and vows not to risk anyone's life like that again. One thing that made me vent large amounts of hate was the fact that Bruce Wayne in this story was drawn like a typical anime pretty boy, to the point I'd welcome Adam West over this design. And while I'm complaining, why the fuck does Batman look like a Tengu? The giant bird nose and diamond eyes were just stupid looking. Plus, as much as I respect Rob Perlson, was it really necessary for him to use his Raphael voice as the role of Sal Maroni? I kept expecting him to pull some side knives out on Batman. The story in itself was good at showing a technological side point of Batman's career, but it crippled the action segments. Overall, horrible design, Bat-Bishojin for the fail, and kind of an empty story. D-. In Darkness Dwells. Batman is on the trail of the Scarecrow and Killer Croc, an 8-foot nightmare responsible for a number of attacks in Gotham City. Batman is infected by Scarecrow's fear toxin, but manages to kill Croc and destroy Scarecrow's lair. without dying from insanity or blood loss. Of course. When I read this one was drawn by the people behind Cardcaptors, I said to myself, oh Christ, a fruity-looking Batman with a card collection, here we come. But that notion was quickly silenced as the story began. The art direction was average. It reminded me too much of Marvel Zombies. Killer Croc is huge and not bad compared to some of his other animated incarnations. And Scarecrow's design is a vast improvement over the movie design. I still have issues with the Japanese directors giving Batman supernatural powers. He turns into a puff of smoke and vanishes down a drain. Japan? Let me make it simple for you. Batman does not have superpowers. Plus, there were some major lip-syncing issues, and I just wish Kevin Conroy would put more emotion into the voice. When he was injected with the fear toxin, he talks as if nothing's wrong. Overall, not bad. Killer Croc was dealt with too easy, and Conroy might as well have been the robot from the first story. B. Working through pain. While injured in the sewers, Batman remembers the teachings he learned from Cassandra on how to use his pain to his advantage instead of letting it consume him. This one was just too deep and spiritual for me, and I felt there was a major plot error inside this story. These stories are set within the Chris Nolan Batman universe, where Batman goes directly to South Asia. He never goes to India once, so that I felt was odd. It also makes it more confusing when the Tim Burton Batmobile makes an appearance instead of the Batman Begins Bat-Tank. There's not much to say about this one. One thing I did like was the Batman design in this one looks like the one from Year One, created by Frank Miller. Overall, too deep. D. And finally, Deadshot. The story begins with this detailed assembly of a rifle. An assassin named Deadshot is hired to kill James Gordon in an effort to get rid of Batman. Batman eventually takes down Deadshot using a shameless amount of bullet time. At the end, he's left with this, should I keep doing this type complex. This one was really well drawn, fantastic musical score, and the lighting was just perfect. But the problem with this story, it's just not on par with Crossfire. The character Deadshot was fleshed out more than the other villains in this movie, and Alfred was used in greater detail. Overall, it's good, but not as good as Crossfire. A. Now these are just my general thoughts regarding Gotham Knight. One problem that I've got with it is the fact there are several different Batman designs throughout this entire movie. You can call it movie if you want, but there we go. This, I felt, kind of crippled it. It should have been one design, one artist, and one art direction. It felt too much like some weird collab video you'd find on Newgrounds.com. I can understand what they were trying to do with this movie. They had some good intentions with the whole thing, but the problem with it is most of these stories are too short, all the different art directions kind of cripple it, and it could have been a bit longer. This could have been a good animated series made from Japan that consisted of about 20 episodes, but what we're left with is sort of like an unfinished project. If there's another Batman movie, maybe we'll see another one of these. But overall, my advice is just rent this. It's something you're not really going to go back to. Once you've seen it once, there's no real surprise with it. Overall, I'd have to give Batman Gotham Knight a C. Rent it and nothing else. I'm Random DC. Good night and good luck. Fatality.